back to back, being back. Look at that. What are the expressions for the end term of the sequence? Now you look at this one, you realize that the values are decreasing. The values are decreasing. Therefore, the value you want to attach to an end has to be a negative. If it is decreasing, the value has to be negative. If it is increasing, the value has to be positive. Now we take the second one, which is negative 2 minus 2, which is equal to negative 4. You can also say negative 6, which is this one, minus 2, which is equal to negative 6 plus 2, which is equal to negative 4. In other words, we realize that it's a decrease here, and if it's decreasing, we are going to target a negative value. So that means it, and you are supposed to write the fifth term after we are done here. Now, so this difference is negative 4. The value is decreasing in the same amount. We begin with negative 4 n. Now, looking at that, the first term being positive 2, then what? When n is 1, when n is 1, it's negative 4 times 1, it's negative 4. So we are going to take the first term, which is 2, minus 4. So we are taking 2 minus nx, which is 2 minus 4, which means 2 plus 4 is going to be 6. Now, the term root is going to be negative 4n plus 6. Now, after that, we are supposed to work out negative 4n, which is this one, this one, this one, and this. Now we need that to calculate it. After that, you are going to get negative 4n plus 6. So negative 4, this drag down negative 4n plus 6, here will be 2. Negative 4n is here, plus this 6, negative 2. Then we have negative 4n, which is this one, plus 6, which is negative 6. Then negative 20 plus 6 will be negative 14. So that is how it is supposed to go. After you've gotten this value, you can indicate this value, this column here. Then you have your answer. Now work out the difference. Work out the term for the equation, nth term, and work out the 11th term. Now, you see, we are moving from negative 1, negative 3, negative 1, then positive 1. What's happening here? These values are increasing, therefore, we are going to record the value we are supposed to attach to n, a positive value, or rather a positive sign. So then we are going to look for the difference. So negative 1 minus minus 3 will give you positive 2. 1 minus minus 1 will give you positive 2. In other words, these values are increasing by 2. The difference is 2, and the value is increasing with the same amount each time. We begin with 2n. Now the first term we have here is negative 3. Now when n is equal to 1, 2 times 1 is equal to 2. Negative 3 minus 2 is equal to 5, negative 5. Our term rule will be negative 2n minus 5. So, having 2n minus 5, then we are going to have our 2n in this place. After that, we are going to have our 2n minus 5. In other words, 2 minus 5 will give you negative 3, 4 minus 5 will give you negative 1, 6 minus 5 will give you 1, 22 minus 5. 17. Then you take these values and you duplicate them. You calculated our term as we were structured. Now, work out the expression for the nth term of the sequence and work out the 13th term. Now, we have 9.5, 7.5, 3.5.5. In other words, you look at this one, the value is decreasing. In other words, what I'm trying to say is that the value we are going to get has to be, n has to be attached to the negative one because this sequence is an increase, a decrease changes. So and you listen to the show. Now, so that means we are all dealing with negative. And now that being said, first term is 9.5, when n equal to 1, we are saying negative 2 times 1, which is negative 2. Then we take the first term minus this one. So first term minus minus 2 is going to give us 9.5 plus 2, which is 11.5. Now, the value which we are supposed to attach, it should be 11.5. Now, the value we are supposed to attach here should be 2n plus 11.5. 2n plus 11.5. Now, so what's happening here? You multiply negative 2n, you get that, negative 2n, you get that, negative 2, 3n, you get that, then to the 13, you get this one. So after that, I want to get negative 2n plus 11.5. So I want to get 9.5. Same as this one, 7.5. And this is 5.5. Then this should be negative 14.5. Negative 14.5. 14.5. You should try 14.5. Now, example number 7. Example number 7, work out the expression for that one and for the 20th term. Look at these values. These values are decreasing. If you want to know that they are decreasing, take this, minus this, and take this, this. And they are decreasing by 5. Another one, n you are going to be, attach n to the negative value, sign that. Being 5, negative 5, you're going to have negative 5n. Now, after that, first term is this one, when n is 5, you're going to have negative 5. So, first term minus this one, first term minus this one, negative 17. How this one is negative 17 plus 5, negative 12. In other words, we're going to have our 5n minus 12. Now, having 5n minus 12, then maybe 5n for all of them here, then for the 20th, 5n is that one. Then maybe 5n minus 12, this will give you negative 17, will give you negative 22, will give you negative 27, will give you negative 112. Now, to our n example, our eighth example, and work out the expression for the nth term. For the sequence, work out the 30th term. So 1, 7, 13. Look at that. There's an increase. There's an increase here. And when there's an increase, what we are going to do here, we are going to attach n to a positive value. We're going to attach n to a positive value. Then, and the difference is 6. So we're going to have 6n. We're going to give it 6. 6n. Now, for us to calculate the amount, or rather the number we're going to attach to n, so we calculate when n is 1, 6 plus 1, yeah, this one, 1 minus 6, we're getting 5. So time is equal to 6n minus 5. 6n minus 5 is what you want to have on the terminal. Then 6n here, then 6n minus 5, 1, 7, 13, 1, 17, 5. That means that. Then 209, for example, work out the expression for the nth term of the sequence and work out 300 term. 300 times 7 to 8 to 9. This is an increase. That means n is going to be attached to a positive value. So they are increasing by 1. So each time, and then we are going to have 1 n here with us. Having one end with us, we begin now with that. Then we can look at the first term. First term here is 27. First term is 27. First term is 27. Then, when n is equal to when n is equal to 1, we are going to have 1 times 1 is equal to 1. So, for us, we find the term there. We are going to take the first term minus what we call it. Yeah, well, first term minus, which is 27, minus this value we've gotten here, which means we're going to get 26. Now, our term rule will be n. Term rule is equal to n plus 26. Now, so this one is when we had begun with 1. But now, so we're going to have n plus 26 here, n plus 26, which is our n. If it's 1, we add 1 here, which means this is going to be 27. We add 2, 28. We add 3, 29 here. Then, when we add 300, it's going to be 326 here, not 326. Now, that's the tenth example, and we are going to stop there, and you are going to get your example in Google Classroom. You have these slides there. Thank you.